Hi, let's talk about the left ventricle. In this video, we'll discuss the structures unique to the left ventricle. So the left ventricle is going to receive blood from the bicuspid or mitral valve, recalling that it has anterior and posterior cusps. Just like the right ventricle, these cusps are going to be attached to papillary muscles via tendinous cords or cordae tendineae. There will be anterior and posterior papillary muscles that correspond to the anterior and posterior cusps of the bicuspid valve, but there isn't any fidelity between the cordae tendineae between the cusps and the papillary muscles. There are also meaty beams or trabecula carnae that form the wall, or the inner lining of the wall of the left ventricle. We could see them better here. We can also see how very thick the myocardium is, keeping in mind that the left ventricle has the thickest or most robust myocardium of the entire heart. Blood is going to be squeezed out from the left ventricle through the aortic valve into the ascending aorta. Now let's think about the valves that are associated with that left ventricle. There is the bicuspid or mitral valve with anterior and posterior cusps. There's also an aortic valve that is adjacent to that. And during systole, the aortic valve is wide open, the bicuspid valve is shut. During diastole, the aortic valve, is closed, the bicuspid valve is wide open. Now that aortic valve has three cusps to it, a right, a left, and a posterior cusp, sometimes called the non-coronary cusp. Each of these cusps are going to separate the right ventricle from the root of the aorta. And the spaces above these cusps are known as the aortic sinuses, or the sinuses of Valsalva. So I'm coloring in the right aortic sinus. That's going to serve the right coronary artery. Now I'm coloring in the left coronary sinus, which serves the left coronary artery. And it's important to remember that the coronary arteries are going to receive their blood when these valves are closed. So they will receive their blood during diastole. So we have discussed the structures that are peculiar to the left ventricle, as well as the specifics of the aortic valve, the cusps, and the aortic sinuses. Thank you very much for your time.